Hey. I am glad you're with me today, and we're going to do part five of the top 40 questions today. I think we got some good ones today, and obviously, if you want to join in, all you have to do is click down below and leave a comment, and I'll try to get to your questions and comments before the end of this little live episode. All of these are being saved to go over to the blog. We're making a new top 40 list as these have gotten updated. But I'm going to go ahead and get on with the first one. Hey, Mark. Hola. First one in. Anyway, we're going to start covering these real quick. And I'm going to go through them. And hopefully everybody will be able to follow along here. We've already done, I think, 20 of these. This is the next five of them, and we'll get going. The first one is, do I steam buns? Abso-freaking-lutely, you steam buns. There's the short answer. Abso-freaking-lutely, steam your buns. You have to steam your buns. It's a must. It's an imperative. There's ways to do it, though. I can give you a different trick. There's two. Two main ways. One is, on a bright sunny day, even if it's not even that warm out, you can set the bags on top of your bread box and they will steam inside the bag. There's enough moisture in there that it will create a softer bun. It's not my favorite way, but it absolutely works. Thanks for y'all for joining. We got Boss Dogs in the house and Alpha Dogs in the house. Mark's here, the Great American. And so we have... I like steaming buns. If you've ever been to Crystal's or White Castle, you know what I'm talking about. Steamed buns are the best buns, period, by far. Nothing beats it. It's the best. I like to take my buns, the steamed buns. In fact, I heard somebody today using those Hawaiian King buns. They give it a sweet flavor. But I like to do a rapid steam. And if you don't know what that is, I posted a video on the blog. Just look up rapid or on this page down below, you'll see it says rapid steam. I did a video to show how to rapid steam. You can rapid steam dogs, sausages, anything you want, but buns, you can rapid steam them so quick and it never slows you down. Every time you take some two out, three out, put three, you know, out of the pan, you put three in and you're constantly moving like this. It works every time, and it doesn't take but a few seconds to steam a bun good. If you're setting up for the day, you can lay out your buns on a table. I showed that in a video where I laid them out, and they steam up. Makes them soft inside the bag, and just saves you time if you're in a big, big hurry and don't have time to do an extra chore, basically, in your serving. But it is worth it every time. I can't imagine getting a bag of Crystal Burgers and it didn't have steamed buns in it. I'd turn around and be pissed off. That's my favorite part of that place, is the steamed buns with the onion flavor. So that's the first one. That was the first one. Do I steam buns? So that gets a big hell yeah. Now, This, believe it or not, this is number 22, most asked thing or most talked about thing that I get from new vendors, first day vendors, first week vendors, is I'm scared to death. Fear sets in and they call Ben. I think I'm going to just sell this. It's just, this scares me to death. And that is normal. It's natural. To a lot of people, it's not an unnatural emotion to have fear, to get in front of people, to, oh man, you know, I remember doing my first podcast ever and I wasn't even seeing anybody and nobody was seeing me. And I was doing the hot dog vendor radio show and I was going, oh my gosh, I stammered and stuttered around. I was nervous as a long-tailed cat in a room full of rocking chairs, nervous. And it just, you get over it. And you get over it quick. In fact, once you get home and you start counting your money, it has some kind of pain relief mechanism, money does, over fear. And usually that fear would just be gone. Ron says, I'm going to throw this up there, Ron. That's a good comment. Fear of the unknown. And that's true. We got David Rambo here from Hot Dog Dave. And let's see, Mark, Troy, Ron Pendleton, thank y'all for joining me. I'm going to go on. I'm going to throw this back up here real quick. Bottom line is, get over it. I promise you, once you start bringing home money in your pockets, it goes away. That fear goes away and you get more and more comfortable and more confident, and you don't even worry about the fear ever again. It goes away. It melts. Okay. It just happens. Mark says he's got a rule. He says it's rule number 4, act like you've been there before. And the nice part is people don't even know if this is your 5,000th day or your first day. So whatever you're doing right according to them, because they don't have a gauge to judge you from. You just do your job and just go at it. Have fun. Be fun. Don't worry about stuff. If you missed any of the past questions about what if I drop my tongs or drop my dog, we cover that. That's some of the fears that people face. David says, howdy to everybody. Here's another one. And this goes back to fear too. Fear I won't do good. Okay. It was kind of like yesterday's about what if no one shows up? Well, they always show up. There's always going to be somebody show up. Okay. But you could have a crappy day. Okay. And I've had them. And, but only $70 a day. I remember thinking $93 I made on my first day, $93, and going, oh my gosh, I'm going to need to find like lunch schedules all day long so that I got to make more than $93, right? Well, what happens if you check out the free training at learnhotdogs.com at the top of the page, it says free training. Okay. You will quickly narrow down the best times and best places to set up. And we did one show on 100 different locations that nobody thinks of. We did one of those shows. You can go get that information for free. You don't have to wonder where to set up. My biggest problem after about a week or two in was, oh my gosh, I need more carts. Okay. And more people running carts. So that's not an issue. $70 a day ain't bad. Let's say you go work, 2 hours or 3 hours and you made $70, not a bad hourly wage, but obviously you can't get by working 2 hours a day unless your income, you know, unless it's $250 an hour. But you'll find the locations where you can make $250 an hour or $150 an hour, $100 an hour. Heck, I mean, it's just awesome. So don't worry about those. The next one, getting stuff to the cart if you can't park close. I understand this. I got a little wagon. Okay. My first gig where I had to actually tote stuff, I learned real quickly, instead of making 11,700 trips, I was going to get me a little wagon. And I got one of these little yard carts and loaded it down with sodas and stuff. And my cooler even would slide in it and I'd pull that sucker. Okay. And I was doing it was a flea market deal. It was kind of like, it's like an antique market, and I had to go up a little ramp and everything. And it was just, the first time I did it with the carrying it all, I didn't want to do that again. Plus at the time I weighed about 75 pounds more than I do right now. And so it was hard just toting around myself, much less, two cases of cans, drinks every trip, over and over. So get you a little cart. You'll figure out your things. You'll figure out what works best for you. But these are good questions. They're still my most asked 40 questions. So that's what I do there. This one we kind of answered the other day, or did answer the other day, and it's about boiling, when to turn the flames off. Now, this depends on the size of the dog, how frozen it is. Like I've got, I used to have one of those sub-zero freezers, and you could drop it down to like 18 below zero. And the problem with that is it takes longer to thaw. It's great in concept, but I'm not storing it for eons. So I buy dogs, let's say at Sam's Bakers and Chefs, or now it's called the Baker's version. But either way, if I buy those dogs and stick them in the freezer, I don't want them frozen at negative numbers. I want them just below freezing. Then they thaw out quicker. But depending on how cold all that is and how many you put in there, I turn off my flames. Okay. When I take my tongs and my dog starts getting loose. Okay. Because it's already cooked. These are pre-cooked dogs. So once it's kind of floppy like this, like a fish, I will just turn off the heat completely. Now, if you have, let me show you something on the board here. Hopefully you can see me. I'm going to slide over and maybe maybe right about here. All right. Maybe you can see that. Okay. So on our carts at hotdogcartstore.com, we set them up a little different than most, because a lot of manufacturers, they have a full size steam pan and they have one burner. Okay. One burner to do all that pan. Well, you can't like have part heat here and hotter heat here or whatever. And so depending on how you do it, like let's say you get a big dog cart and it's got a half pan here, a third pan here, and you're direct heating. I'll cook my dogs in this third pan. Okay. I'll boil them here. Sometimes I'll do 2/3 pans and boil them through here too. Right. Then I have a full size over here that's in a steam. Okay. It's in a water pan. Okay. A spillage pan, they call it. And I'll have that water pan going. And when I turn these off, I'm getting reserve heat from here. This burner stays on and it keeps this stuff hot. And then when I get low over here, I will transfer dogs to here. Okay. Just the few that are left, grab another batch out of my freezer. Okay. And have them boiling again, turn these back on and go to town. And if I'm real busy, I'll rotate these two. Okay. Like when this one is ready to turn off, I've move them over, start another batch, and then I'll keep it going like that. And that way I have one warm and one heating all the time. And then my steam for my reserves. That's what I do. I hope that made sense to you. Let's see. Believe it or not, that was it. That was the five. I ran through those quick today. I'm going to go through some of these real quick. Larry says, howdy to everybody. I love Mark's comment. I'm going to put it back up again. Hello. Howdy, all. David says, howdy. Kenny says, hello, all. Catering for You is in the house. Hey, Ken Packer. Good to see you, brother. Troy Thomas. Let's see. Hi, Kenny and Dave. Mark Payne, Woo Doggy's wife, says my hat came in the mail today. Heck yeah. Awesome. He's talking about these hats. These are for our Street Food Pro team, our Vendors United. Sign up for Vendors United. That's right. Let's see. I boil mine. Yeah, the hats are free. If you're a member in the group, they're free. Let's see here. Mark says, sign up. Good show, Davis, Alpha Dogs. Thank you a bunch. We're going to have more tomorrow. I'm going to do two shows tomorrow, the normal 3:30 show with the Q&A, and then we'll do another show probably earlier tomorrow with the next five on the top 40 list. B&T Catering, Northern California. Freaking awesome, Brian. Glad you're here. Bill and Jenny Weber. Got my umbrella. Cool. That's cool. I like our umbrellas. Let's see. I've got to get this thing out of my dang way because it's blocking my screen. All right. I'm glad y'all were here. I hope you enjoyed this. Thanks for the tips. Troy says, thanks for the tips. I'm out. See y'all later. Troy, have a good one. I appreciate y'all a bunch, and I'll be back tomorrow. Two different shows. If you miss them, they'll be saved here on the Facebook page. I appreciate y'all. And I'm going to be sharing something cool today on the Facebook. So if you get a notification about it, share it with people that might be interested. That'll help me out. I'd appreciate it a bunch. Love you guys, girls, all of you. And I'll talk to you later.